music you've just been listening to, which was on the opening credits for this End Times Coming special presentation, was composed by the German composer Richard Strauss. It is, of course, his four last songs. Richard Strauss, of course, was a celebrated German composer. And at the end of the Second World War, he was composed this moving piece of music. And I believe some months afterwards, he died quietly in his bed. Not so for the poor Italian gentleman who was brought here some 15 years ago, I believe. And his name was Roberto Calvi, the man they infamously called God's banker. This is the infamous spot where Roberto Calvi was brought one dark, lonely night. I suspect that he was in a state of fear. I should say paralyzed by fear. His moustache had been shaven off, a moustache he had had since he was a young man. He wore no tie. His pockets were stuffed with bricks and stones and loose change. He was brought to this place, and at that time, underneath these girders, was scaffolding. I was last here some 12, perhaps 15 years ago, and at the time, there was scaffolding all the way along here, and this was the scaffolding that Roberto Calvi was hung from. Today, that scaffolding is no longer here, but if you look down, you can see the force of the pressure where he would have been brought, possibly over under that bridge there, in a motorboat, by four or five people, would have brought him here. Here you have the ladder, just here, if you could hone in on this. And he would have been brought up this ladder where the scaffolding met it, and there he was hung. His crime was that he knew too much. As God's God's banker, he was chairman of the Banco Ambrosiano, a heavily supported bank by the Vatican. Roberto Calvi was hung here, I believe, as a sacrificial lamb, because he knew too much, and it has all the symbols of a Masonic execution in the fact that his moustache was shaved, as I say, rocks were in his pocket, and he was hanging under Blackfriars Bridge. This whole area, of course, christened the City of London, is very much an area still riddled with the occult, Freemasonry, and the Illuminati. Some 16 or so years later, the family of Roberto Calvi still cry for justice for their father and for their husband. Mrs. Calvi is convinced that it was dark forces of the Mafia, of the Vatican, and of the underworld that brought her husband to this terrible spot where he was hung up and where he was hung until he died. At the time I came here, all this was open, and there were young men living rough here at the time in duffel bags and sleeping bags. And I asked one young man, I said, what's it like here at night? He said, it's a terrible place. There's a terrible atmosphere. He said, I believe someone was murdered from this bridge, hanging from this bridge. And I mentioned Roberto Calvi, and it said it may have been him. So this has just been a revisit. Nothing much has changed here. There's a very heavy, sinister atmosphere. But we call for justice, we await justice with the Calvi family, that one day soon, the murderers who murdered Roberto Calvi on this bridge will one day be brought to judgment. They may have escaped justice in this life, but these men will not escape it when God judges again. All have to be born again. The wide road will be wide. The gate to heaven will be narrow. For Roberto Calvi, it may be too late for him. He may not have been saved, but he was certainly murdered on this bridge. Today we have visited it. Today we can say it was very much the same. Roberto Calvi, this is the bridge where he was hung. From this ministry, we wish you goodbye and Maranatha.